The name Don DeGrate is a household name in gospel music circles. This dear brother is a singer, songwriter, worship leader, and pastor approaching 50 years of ministry with no signs of stopping. We'll talk with Don DeGrate here today on Babbie's House. Stay tuned. Babbie's House is coming your way right now.
Every day is filled with possibility. At Babbie's house, Babbie's house, everybody is family. Oh, welcome to Babbie's house.
Hello, everyone, and welcome. Welcome to Babbie's House, where everybody is a member of the family, and that always includes you. Thanks for joining me today. Well, I am so excited to have none other than Don DeGrate as my special guest today here on Babbie's House. I have loved his music for decades, and this dear brother is using all the gifts that God has given him and so much more. He's approaching almost 50 years in ministry, and that just lets us know that there is no expiration date on God's plan for our life. So he's going to tell us about what God is doing in his life, and he's also going to sing for us. So don't go away, because this is going to be a wonderful show, a show that will be certain to encourage you. Well, I'm going to sing a couple of songs for you, or sing a song for you that I wrote many years ago, but I'll tell you the message still stands strong. And it takes me to Matthew chapter 5, verse 16, that says, "Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven."
In the parking lot of the coffee shop just the other day, she smiled and she said, "Well, I'm doing okay," and I felt her pain. I took her hand in mine, said, "It's gonna work out fine." But as she turned, I wondered, did I just hand her a lie? What she needed most was a word of hope and a prayer or two, a little more time and a timely word could have pulled her through. And so I think of her and I wonder too, is anybody hurting sitting right next to you? Shine the light, share your faith, show the world that Jesus is the answer, Jesus is the way. Together we can make a difference, be a beacon in the dark of night. Share your faith, hold it high, shine the light. Anywhere you go, in a country or city, in a lonely life, a hurting heart, somebody in need, they all ask one thing: where is love and truth? But if you know Jesus, then you know what to do. Thank you.
Welcome back to the show. Let me introduce my very special guest today. His name is Don DeGrate, and he is an amazing, iconic gospel singer, songwriter, preacher, worship leader, concert artist, and God has blessed his life, and there's no signs of stopping for this dear brother who is approaching almost 50 years in ministry. Will you help me to welcome to Babbie's house, Don DeGrate? My friend, I'm happy
Thank
to have you.
Thank you. Thank you. What
Thank
a
you.
Joy.
What a joy to have you.
I thought I'd never sit on this couch. But now I
feel
special.
Well, amen. We can tick that box off. Well, I want, you know, I'm always interested to know how Christian artists get started in ministry. What was that story like for you?
Well, of course, raised in church. And I got started singing in a little Baptist church called Tarvis Chapel Missionary Baptist Church in Waco, Texas.
All right.
The church in the heart of the city with everybody in the heart.
I like that.
But God is good. Then I went on to start singing for that day. It was called R&B. And I was 17 years old, singing church choir and singing with an all-Mexican band.
That's amazing.
They call me the Blaxican.
I love it.
But we played R&B and got out of high school, went to college for some time, went on to California and then the military, and ended up in Virginia. And I'm pushing the button real fast forward. And started working for a church there, St. John Church of God in Christ in Virginia, Pastor Green. He knew Pat Robertson.
Yes.
For CBN.
Yes.
And so Pat heard me sing with the choir and offered me a job at CBN working. I think I was a salesman then. That kind of fell through. And so he put me behind the camera, and then he made me talent coordinator. And so I would bring in guests from the city, and everybody had to come through me to actually sing on the 700 Club.
That's amazing.
Well, he opened a station in Atlanta, Channel 46. And so he said, Don, we're opening in Atlanta, and we have a large black community. What do you think we should do? I said, one thing, they got to watch y'all talk all night, like, for sure. You need to have a music show. So he thought about that. And I was living in Portsmouth, Virginia. And so he brought me to Atlanta and asked me to host a show. So he said, we got to start a music show. So he asked me to host a show until they found a host. I was flying back and forth from Charlotte, from Virginia. And he said, we need to name your show something. He said, can we call it Black is Beautiful? I said, no, that's kind of controversial right now. He said, the black people have a slang? I said, right on,
right
brother.
On.
He said, if it's not right on, I'm going to take it right off. So anyway,
I
came to Atlanta.
Something big.
And we started here in Atlanta, moved to Portsmouth, then I went to D.C. I'm going fast, Hartford, Connecticut. And the thing that really broke it was he started a pack of 700 Club, the Jim and Tammy Show.
Yes.
Right On, and Bozo the Clown.
Those are some iconic shows, and you know, we remember them all. We remember them.
Well, Bozo didn't do too well with 700, with Pat Robertson, so he had 700.
He was in our market growing up in Michigan. I remember him well. So you are approaching 50 years in ministry. What do you think, you know, in our culture, that's a time to retire? You know, people, once you work on a job for 30 years or 35 years, you get your pension, you go find a rocking chair, you look at the sunset, and you call it a retirement. But God calls us not to retire, but to refire.
Yeah.
You know, what do you think is the key to your longevity?
Well, I love the Lord for one, and I eat right, and I pray right. But God has been good to me. My wife said, when are you going to stop singing? I say, at my funeral, I'm going to raise up and sing my last song. But
I love it.
I don't know. I give God all the glory.
Yes.
I feel good. And I've had some, you know, challenges, but God has healed me and brought me through.
Yes.
And so it's amazing.
Amen.
I'm just glad.
So you're pastoring now.
Yes, ma'am.
In Charlotte, North Carolina.
Yes, ma'am.
How long have you been pastoring?
Too long. I mean, that's 49 years coming up.
Wow. So have you been pastoring the full length of your music ministry?
Yes.
Okay. So how did you balance it all with family, with the road? Because I know you tour, you had a band. There's a lot of music out there on the internet. And we, of course, we watched you at the Joyful Noise Christian Supper Club here in Atlanta, Georgia, and sang on the stage with you at that time. And so how did you keep all of that straight with a family?
Well, I never did Sundays. I'd always come home for church on Sundays. And I was told that that was going to hurt my career because I had to do Sundays. But I would never do Sundays. I think I've done probably, in all those years, maybe 10 Sundays in the last 40-some years, if that many. But I'd come home through the week, and I'd do like, I guess, Wednesday through Fridays, and come home. And I've maintained, had the same wife for 55 years coming up.
That's amazing. Congratulations. Well, being a man of God and a man of the Word, what would you say is one of those passages of Scripture that just seems to be a guidepost for you in your life and ministry?
Well, there are so many. You got me, oh man. I can't just pinpoint one thing. It's been all good.
Yeah. Well, when you get on stage, and today, when you minister to us, what do you hope people that will gain from your ministry?
Well, the songs I'm going to do today, I wrote those at a time that I was probably going through some things. And I told a man that today, a lot of songs are not born out of experience.
Yes.
People write songs for hits. And that's not the way to write a song, I don't
Amen.
Think. You know, like the old songwriters never wrote a song for it. That didn't even exist back in those days.
Amen.
Like Amazing Grace, There's a Fountain, you know, those are songs
yes.
from my heart. But I'm hoping that the songs will minister and touch lives. On God alone you can depend. The love of Jesus, you know, that's what's brought me through. You know, and I've had some ups and downs. Of course, you don't know anything about that. But
yes, I do. I'm married with a family.
But the Lord bless us. We raised three kids, and they've done well. I'm not happy with some of the decisions they've made, but God has blessed them. And, of course, my wife has been, oh, if I could write a book about a wife, be my wife. She has been the perfect
that
example
so
of a wife. She's had my back. She's prayed for me. I mean, she should have walked out and left me alone, but she said, as a matter of fact, she was advised to leave me one time.
And she was advised to leave you?
Yeah, by a spiritual leader.
Wow,
leave
what?
And she said, I ain't going nowhere. She said, I didn't leave him when he was up. I'm not going to leave him when he's down. She said,
Amen.
I made a vow.
Yes.
And so she's
That's beautiful.
A woman of God. You know,
well, you give her our love and just tell her that we congratulate her. We celebrate her and we celebrate you. Now, what are you going to sing for us today?
On God Alone. And because of your precious love.
Now, you wrote both of these songs.
Yes, I did.
So tell me, you know, as a songwriter, I understand that, you know, that process of hearing from the Lord and then watching that song come from a seed of a inspiration to a song with that's fully orchestrated and arranged. So tell me about God Alone.
Yeah.
How was it inspired?
The words are, every road, there's an end. You know, every problem, there's an answer.
Yes.
On God alone, you can depend.
Yes.
And some people make the journey, some give up, you know. But depending on the Lord is how you're going to make it through.
That's right.
And that's basically what a song says.
Amen. Well, let me just say, we are so happy to have you on the show today.
Oh, I'm happy to be here.
We are so honored. And, you know, I look at your life and ministry almost 50 years because I've admired you from, you know, from back in the 70s when I was first coming into music ministry and looking for those iconic people who were singers and songwriters whose lives that I could emulate and imitate, and your music and your...
Oh, thank you.
Oh, I'm so serious.
Don't make me cry.
Well, I want to just say thank you for your consistency. And so in closing, one last comment. If there was something that you wanted people to know about you, just that one thing you talk about, you know, singing at your funeral. Well, if we saw it in print, what was that one thing you would want us to know?
Trust God with everything. I mean, make God first above everything else. You know, He has been the light of my life. And if I had time, I could tell you all the miracles that God has done. And seek Him first.
Yes.
His kingdom. Amen. And things will follow.
Amen. Well, that's beautiful. That's a beautiful word from the Lord and a beautiful testimony. You sit right there and relax yourself. Get your me's in order because you're going to answer la 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 because you're going to sing for us in just a moment. So sit right there. And you, my friend, you sit right there as well because after this break, we are going to hear from the impeccable, the one and only Brother Don DeGrate. Stick around. Babbie's House is coming your way right after this break. I am so glad you came back to the show. Let me introduce my very special guest, singer, songwriter, pastor, worship leader, Don DeGrate.
Listen.
For every question, there's an answer. For every road, there is an end. For what you need to know and for where you have to go, on God alone, you can depend. Oh, yes. For every question, there's an answer. There's an answer. For every road, there is an end. Oh, Lord. For what you need to know and for where you have to go, on God alone,
I know
you can depend. Listen, some make the journey, others don't, the road's too rough. Some look for the key, others won't, they just give up. Trying to do it by themselves without the help of someone else. He can show you how,
he
can help you now. For every question, there's an answer.
For every road, there is an end.
There's an end. For what you need to know and for where you have to go, on God alone, I know
you can depend.
Listen. Some make the journey, others don't. The road's too rough. They look for the key, others won't. They just give up. Trying to do it by themselves without the help of someone else. He can show you how.
He can show you how.
He can help you now.
Hey.
For every question, there's an answer. There's an answer. For every road, there's an end. There's an end. For what you need to know and for where you have to go. On God alone, I know you can depend. Hey.
For every question,
there's an answer. For what you need to know and for where you have to go. On God alone, I know, you can depend. Listen.
You can depend on my God.
I know.
You can depend on him.
He'll never let you down, no.
You can depend
on Jesus.
Oh,
I know you can depend on him. But where you have to go, on God alone, on Jesus, you can depend. I know.
On God alone,
I know you can depend.
You can depend.
Hey.
On God alone,
hey.
You can depend.
Hey. Ah, thank you, Lord. Lord, I thank you for your love today. My love song to Jesus. Mm-hmm. Oh, yes. Lord, if you hadn't come for me, I'd be drowning in the sea of misery. If you didn't love me so, I would never even know where to go.
Without your precious love,
singing
like a morning dove, lifting my soul beyond the sky, I could never fly so high. It's because of
your love,
your precious love.
Lord, if you hadn't pulled me through, I don't know what I would do without you. If everything else was dismissed, your precious love would still exist. I know this.
Hey. Without your precious love, singing like a morning dove, lifting my soul beyond the sky, I could never fly so high. It's because of,
thank you, Lord,
your precious love.
Lord, if you hadn't heard me cry when I thought that I would die, I can't deny. If there was no one else to care, your precious love still be there. You'd be there.
Without your precious love,
singing
like a morning dove, lifting my soul beyond the sky, I could never fly so high. It's because of,
thank you, Lord,
your precious love.
Oh,
without your precious love,
singing like a morning dove,
singing like a morning dove,
lifting my soul,
lifting my soul beyond the sky,
I could never fly,
I could never
so
fly
high,
so high. It's because of
your love, your love,
your precious love. It's because of your precious love.
Thank you for your love, Jesus.
It's because of
your love, your precious
love.
Oh yeah. Ooh yeah. Thank you, Lord.
My friend, that was beautiful. Yeah, well, we're not quite done. I'm going to close the show, but you stay right there, okay? Stand here with me. Precious friend, thank you for watching Babbie's House today. And thank you, Brother Don DeGrate, for leading us into the presence of the Lord and telling us your story.
Yes.
Amen. We're so happy to have you on the show. Listen, I want you to reach out to me on my official website at Babbie.com, first name only, Babbie.com. And there you will find all kind of wonderful resources to encourage you in your faith. All of my music, the scope of my discography, all of my songs are right there at Babbie.com from our store. You can also access e-books and all of my Bible studies and all the books that I've written across the years. You can also access Babbie Mason Radio. When you go to the website, you'll see a little triangular button there on the homepage of the website. It's kind of twirling around there. Click that button, and that will take you to the radio page where you can launch Babbie Mason Radio. And the only thing missing from Babbie Mason Radio is Don DeGrate music. We've got to get your music on Babbie Mason Radio. But you can hear beautiful music and encouraging words 24 hours a day right there on BabbieMasonRadio.com. Well, the Lord bless you, and thank you so very much for watching the show today. And this is my blessing and my prayer for you, that the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Thanks again for watching the show. We'll see you next time. God bless you until then.